Good morning, my dears. How are you all? I hope you all are fine. Me too, fine. Today for grade 6, we are going to be short revise 4th lesson of history. What books and burials tell us? Then we are going to be discuss about map. Okay. So the entire session, first of 5 to 10 minutes, we are going to be recall what up to now you studied from this lesson. Then we are going to discuss about map and important points, important places of the map. We are going to be discussed, right? So, what books and burials tell us in this lesson? We are discuss about 4 Vedas. Okay, so about 4 Vedas we discuss. That is very oldest books in our India. Okay, so what are the 4 Vedas means? Rig Veda, Sam Veda, Yajur Veda, and Atharva Veda. Okay, so Rig Veda, Sam Veda, Yajur Veda, Atharva Veda. Okay, so Rig Veda only the first Veda among these 4. Okay, so all these four Vedas were written in Sanskrit language. So all the 4 Vedas were described in a poem like, okay, so the dialogues or what are the things they explain in this Veda through the method of poem. Okay, so then we discuss about 3 important gods during the Veda period. Okay, during the Veda period they are important, these 3 gods alone. Okay, so one is Agni. Okay, Agni, you know very well, Agni means fire. Okay, so that's why the god of fire. Okay, so they are praying the fire god. Okay, he is called as Agni. And second is Indra. So this god is a warrior god. Okay, a warrior god. And then third one is Soma. So this is a special drink that time, even in our Puranas, our holy books, Hindu holy books, and all they describe about Soma Bana. Okay, what is that Soma Bana means? That nowadays they are taking some drinking items from that alone called as Soma Bana. That are no need for you. Okay, so Soma, a plant from which a special drink was prepared. Okay, so Soma means a plant. So from that plant, a special drink was prepared. Okay, so these 3 god only in those days, the time of Vedic period, the people they are praying. Okay, so next, even in those days, the people were involved in war. Okay, so the time of Vedic time. Okay, Vedic time means when the Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sam Veda, Atharva Veda was composed. In that period, was called as Vedic period. So in that time, there is no regular kings ruling. Okay, so there is no kings ruling. But instead of kings ruling, the people, they organize themselves a committee, a assembly. In that assembly, they discuss themselves about war and peace. Okay, so even those days also, the people, they fought each other. What are the reasons they fight each other means? For capturing land, particularly pastures land. Already I said, in that time, many people, they are started to involve cattle rearing. They gave more important cattle like cow, buffaloes, goat, sheep, horse. Okay, so for capturing these things from other group of people, they are fought war. Okay, they are involving war. Okay, suppose one group of people sit at one place, so that people, they are rearing many animals like horse and buffalo and cow means. So for that, they are conducting war. Other group of people, they are capturing these things, these cattle, they are conducting war. Okay, suppose in Tamil you will study about Thinai, Kanji Thinai, Vanji Thinai, Vichi Thinai. So in that you will study about this game. Okay, so comes to this point. So battle were fought for the land. Okay, so mainly the pasture land, which land where the land is good for rearing animals. So that land and water. Water is very important source even nowadays also. So the land, which land was very good water facility for capturing that land, the people were fought each other. Okay, and for people. Okay, so in those days, which group of people won the war? That people were taking that cattle like cow, buffaloes, and also they are capturing some people in that place. Who defeated? Who was defeated? So that people also taking by these people as a slaves. Okay, so you know very well, slaves means without paying salary, they have to force to work on the field. Okay, so for these, for land, for water, for people, they are involved war. Okay, so there is no regular army. You just keep it in your mind. In those days, in the Vedic period, there is no regular army. So among themselves, they are making assembly and they are meet frequently. That assembly meet frequently and they discuss about war and peace. Okay, so who? So assembly means they need some leader. Okay, so they select their leader. So that leader who was very brave among that group. Okay, so that leader was very brave, very brilliant or very good warrior. He was selected as a leader and he was very skillful. Okay, what problem suppose happen in the group, he have to solve that problem. So that capacity he must have. Okay, so like that only they select their leader. Okay, so in Vedic period, how the people were described? Okay, how the people were described means, yeah, the leader was called as, okay, here I said, no, the leader was rated, he was called as a Raja. Okay, so the group of people who lived in that place, they select their leader. So that leader was later called as a Raja. Okay, he was the head of that group. Okay, after rest of that Raja who are lived means priest. Okay, so particularly this priest were maximum they belongs to Brahmins. Okay, maximum they are belongs to Brahmins. So in those days Brahmins alone allowed to study Veda. Okay, so this Rig Yajur, Sam, Atharva, Veda, we discussed now these four Veda, who only allowed to study means this group of people, this Brahmanas only. Okay, why? Because in those days also caste difference seen everywhere. Okay, so and then Jana. Okay, Jana means the normal people. Okay, and Vishu. Okay, the word Vishu comes from Vaishyas. Okay, see, four category of people, they divide the people into four category. One is Brahmanas, second is Kshatriyas, third is Vaishyas, fourth is Sutradars. Okay, so in Hindu holy book we will discuss means, we will see means how they describe. In fifth lesson we will discuss the Brahmanas. They are born from the head of the Brahma. The Kshatriyas, they born from the shoulder of Brahma, and the Vaishyas, they born from the stomach of Brahma, and the Sutradas, they born from the feet of the Brahma. Like that, they in those days they described. Okay, but the fact that are not true, and then maybe it is imagination only. Okay, so Vaishyas means who involved in trading. Okay, merchants, they are called as Vaishyas. And last category, Dasa and Dasas, Dasis. Okay, Dasas and Dasis, they are slaves. Okay, so in the time of war, who were captured by the Raja or leader, so that people when the gents, the male were called as Dasa and the female were called as Dasis. Okay, so this kind of people were lived in those days. So next we are going to be discuss about megalithic. Megalithic is a burial site. In those days, death. Okay. So even nowadays also, suppose a person was dying, we are do some ritual practice. Okay, whatever religions we are belongs to, whether we are Hindu or Christianity or Muslim, whatever religion we are follow, we are doing some rituals during the time of the burial. Okay, so Mahalathik, it is a burial site. What is the meaning of Mahalathik? Already I said, the stone boulders are known as Mahalathik. The stone boulders are known as Mahalathik. So when a person was died, when he was buried, the surface of earth or underground, in that place they are keeping a very big stone. Okay, for identify, suppose some other people they saw in that place, so they comes to know. So this is a burying site. In this place somebody was buried, so for that identification they are kept a very big stone. They are placing very big stones in that place, right? So used to mark burying site. That is only the reason. Okay, so when a people was buried, sometimes they are buried surface of the earth. Okay, they are not dig very deep, very short, 3 to 4 feet alone they will dig and they buried in that place. Sometimes they are buried very lengthy in underground. Okay, so it may differ according to that area. Okay, so the died person, okay, when the person was died, when he was buried under the ground or surface of the earth, they are kept in a very big pot. Okay, very big pot, then alone they are buried. Okay, along with the pot they are buried. Suppose they are kept there, dead body was kept in that box, that pot. Okay, almost the pot was very high, very tall, and then very, the width also very big. Okay, so in that patch they were kept, and then that whole entire pot will be buried under the earth. Okay, sometimes the archaeologists found, see, that part were belongs to black or red color. Okay, black or red color, that's why that pot were called as black and red ware. Okay, so sometimes the archaeologists found this like burial site. In that part, they are find out some tools and weapons of iron weapons. They found these tools, some tools. They found some ornament, gold ornament and stone ornament. They found some half skeletons in that burial site. They found some half skeletons and horse equipments. That too they found. So what we comes to know means that burial site, they may be buried a superior person or very high class person or like a king like person was buried. Even in the time of burying, the burying site also very different. Okay, each and every burial site is not same. Some site where some skeletons were very less ornament. Okay, even that ornament also not gold or another copper, another metals. Okay, simple metals or stone ornament only that skeletons were there. So what we comes to know, the time of burying also the caste difference they are seeing, the social differences they may see in those days also, right? So with the help of this map, you can understand some places. Okay, so in your book, in this lesson, the fourth lesson, what books and burials tell us in that lesson, the second page of this lesson, that Vishwamitra, the poet Vishwamitra, he explained about two rivers. Okay, exactly what is the book page number means, their book page number 36, the same Vishwamitra, he explained about two rivers. One is Bees and Satluj. Okay, one is Bees and Satluj. These two rivers are tributary rivers of Indus. Okay, already I said what is tributary means, the small rivers which is joined. belt. Where it is located means present day Kashmir and Punjab, and rest of the part, rest of the area located present day Pakistan, right? So Bees and Satluj are the tributary rivers of Indus. So in his hymns, he explained, Vishwamitra explained about these two rivers in your book page number 36. And then in your book page number 41, I think so. In your book page number 41, 1 minute. Yeah, one of the place they mentioned Brahmagiri. Brahmagiri is a megalithic site. Brahmagiri, where it is located, means present day Andhra Pradesh came. So it is a megalithic site. In that site alone, I said, you know, the time of, during time of burying, they are seeing social differences. So in that site, in that place, archaeologists found the different types of burying site they found. Okay, same like in Tamil Nadu state, Adichanallur. Okay, in recent time also in this Adichanallur, they are doing the archaeologists doing research. Okay, so the Adichanallur also a megalithic site. Okay, so the two sites are the Brahmagiri and Adichanallur was very famous. Many burying, the skeletons were found with the equipments, with the jewels, everything. Okay, and then in closer look, page number 41, we discuss about a closer look, Imam Ghan. Okay, so Imam Ghan is located present day Maharashtra. So the river bank of God. Okay, the river bank of God. Okay, so it is a tributary of Bhima. Okay, that Bhima river going to merge, I think so, Godavari river. Okay, so here a small river God is located. So in that place only they found the site, the burial site of Imam Ghan, the archaeologist found. Okay, so you have to know the exact place, that's why I wrote here. So Indus is the river which was situated, which is situated at present in Pakistan. So Bees and Satluj. Okay, so and then Imam Ghan. So Imam Ghan, it is present in Maharashtra. And then Brahmagiri was in Andhra Pradesh, and Adichanallur. So these are the important, see, these two or three are important megalithic site, and the river Bees and Satluj was explained by the poet Vishwamitra and Rig Veda, right? So we are coming to the end of the session. So up to now, what are the things we discussed? Means about four Vedas. Okay, about four Vedas: Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sham Veda, and Atharva Veda we discussed. And three gods, the time of Vedic period, they are celebrate, they are giving more importance of three gods. One is god of Agni, god of Indra, and god of Soma. Okay, that we discussed. And how Vishwamitra explained the river of Bees and Satluj. Okay, Bees and Satluj we discussed, right? And then the life of people. Okay, why the battle war happened, why the war war happened, how they select their leader. Okay, so the during war, what are the things they are captured? So what are the things they capture? Cattles, horse, and people. Cattles, horses, and peoples. Okay, so that we discuss. And then what are the things, and then what we discuss about means the category of people. Okay, so people were categorized by Raja, okay, and priest. So Raja is the head of the person, priest, they are, the priest was belongs to Brahmana community, and the normal people were called as Jana, and the slave people were called as Dasa and Dasis. Okay, that we discuss. And last, what discuss means about megalithic. Okay, about megalithic. So in this topic, we discuss about megalithics. So in this topic, we discuss about burial site. for this session also you have worksheet. You have to go through the entire lesson fully, then you try to answer the question, and you have map question also for this lesson. Okay, so observe the map from the book page number 13. Okay, so for this lesson's map is combined in page number 13 itself. Okay, so you have to refer for marking map. Okay, you have to refer for marking map in the page number marking map in the page number 13. Okay, so page number 13. Okay, so keep it in your mind and then answer the question in correct manner. Right.